936, can you hear me?
Yes, yes,
okay.
I can hear you.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure because I didn't know. All right, so I'll go on. Anyway, so as I was saying, it's important for people to stand up for themselves and actually make sure that they do that. Because without actually doing that, you're saying that your treatment of me is not okay. You're saying that your treatment of me is okay. You're saying that what you've done to me is acceptable, that what you've done to me is, you know, fine with me by not saying anything at all. So anyway, I just wanted to talk about that a little bit tonight because I've noticed that people seem to think it's okay to remain neutral on things and to remain in the middle. And I highly respect people who don't do that. I've known many people, friends and family, like I said, who strive to stay out of the drama, as it's called, or stay out of any kind of conflict in their life. But as the song I just played in the beginning of the show says, if you don't have, what does it say? If you don't have haters, you ain't doing anything, as they say. So if you don't have somebody who doesn't agree, somebody who disagrees with you, or somebody who just doesn't like you because you stand up for yourself, or you've said, this is the way I just demand to be treated, then you're not doing much with your life. You're not standing for shit. And I find that to be abhorrent. And I find it to also be really sad and pathetic. So people who want to just keep peace for peace's sake, I'm sorry, I do not respect that. And that's just me. That's just me. And I have had, as I said, my grandmother was that way. And that's the one trait about her I never respected. And that's the one thing that caused the conflict between she and I, you know, sometimes in the family, especially when my family would mistreat her or my mother or myself. And I would stir the pot and I would say, you know, how dare you act like that? Or how dare you say that to my grandmother or my mother or to me or whatever the case was? How dare you do this? And I would demand them to respect me or say the fuck out of my life. And she just didn't understand that. She was like, why would you say that way? You know, why would you act this way? And she just didn't get it. It wasn't in her consciousness. She didn't understand why someone would not always try to be, you know, to coexist no matter what. Even if it meant, is because it meant to do that meant to squelch my own inner light, to dim my light. That's what I've always called it, to dim my own light and to say that your light shines brighter than mine, that your power as a human being, your spirit, your whatever, it for some reason is more important than my own. And I've always found that to be bullshit, and it is bullshit. And people actually, when they do that, that's what they're saying to themselves and to their person, that you somehow are better than me and more respect than I do. So to me, all of us are fucking human beings. We all take a fucking shit on the fucking toilet, okay? All of us do it. All of us pee. All of us have sex, most of us, hopefully. You know, all of us eat. All of us do these things, these common denominators. You know, we put our pants on two legs at it, one leg at a time, I mean. All of us do these things that are common denominators as human beings. We are all fucking the same. The only thing that divides us is each other. And sometimes it's necessary. And yeah, you know what? Sometimes I am better than somebody else. And sometimes somebody else is better than me at some things. For example, you know, I can't fucking play football. Are you fucking kidding me? Me on a fucking football field? Give me a fucking break. I'd be looking at the fucking guys' asses all the time. That's all I would be doing. You know, I wouldn't be paying attention to the game at all. And a great tennis player. I'm an amazing architect. I'm a really good architect, interior designer. I'm really good at that. So it's very rare, you know, that I would find someone who's better than that at that than I am, or, you know, not as just evil to the core. And people just have no real soul. I mean, there are people like that out there that exist in this world. There are people in this world who actually just are just rotten to the core. People who don't have a real redeeming quality in their fucking body. And, you know, I could name a whole fucking list of them right now. I'm not going to, but I know a bazillion of them I could name right now, okay, that I've known throughout my lifetime. And so what do you do with a kind of person like that? Do you accept them and they remain in your life? Why would you want somebody like that in your life? And to say, yes, you can treat me however you want to treat me because somehow you're better than me? No, fuck that. And I guess because my mother instilled in me that no one is better than you, that you're always, everybody's equal, blah, 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 you know, all kind of crap, you know, which is true, but I'm just saying she instilled that kind of stuff in me as a child. And so I grew up believing that, you know, they probably somehow say that they're a better person than you. I mean, intrinsically, I'm talking about how they do their job, or I'm talking about their sporting ability or their singing ability or things like that. Of course, there are people better than someone else at those things in certain aspects, of course. But I'm saying a real human being, someone who has empathy, is someone who has empathy. What is empathy? Empathy is looking at someone else's life or, you know, seeing what someone else is going through and feeling, emotionally feeling, and a connection with that person and understanding what it means to feel that way, recognizing what it means for that person to feel pain or to feel joy or sorrow, whatever the case is. And it's an identification that, oh, this is another human being. I understand what it means to go through that kind of pain. I would never want to hurt someone that way. That is empathy. Now, someone who lacks empathy, someone who lacks social skills, someone who lacks, you know, truth telling, for example, someone who doesn't know how to tell the fucking truth about anything, you know, is someone who's insecure, someone who doesn't have any real identity or self-identity or self-love. And I find that to be sad. I really do. But there's so many people I know like that, unfortunately. But, you know, whatever. It is what it is. But I just wanted to talk about that briefly because I wanted to say that I don't respect, I guess the basic point I was making is I don't respect people that just stay in the middle. And I talked to David about this before. I'm not talking about you, David, specifically in the chat there. I'm talking about people in general. But David and I had a discussion about something. I don't know. I don't remember what we were talking about, David, but it was a week or two ago, whatever. And I was like, so you don't ever pick sides or whatever. Oh, I know what we're talking about. Never mind. I said, you don't pick sides or whatever. And that, he said, no, I pick sides. And, you know, he said, I'm on this side. And this is what I believe. And said, okay, thank you. So I appreciate that. But have you ever been in a friendship, for example, a friendship or relationship, and the partner you have doesn't take your side on something? You know, they don't actually take your side in what you're talking about or what it is you're going through with this fucking thing. Oh, my God. This is why I don't take fucking phone calls on this fucking thing. I'm going to have a fucking rant again, because this fucking thing is doing it. Did you just lose sound, by the way, in the chat room for a second? Just let me know if you didn't hear me talking for a second. I'm just curious because it says that it dropped the connection again. Yes, a little bit. Fucking piece of shit, goddamn motherfucker. Anyway, so I'm going to play a song, come back, and talk a little bit more, and then we'll be done with the show. I'm only doing a short show, so I'll be right back if I can find something to play. What am I going to play? How about some Whitney Houston? Let's see. Be right back. Here we go.
Dog?
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hey.
Hey.
I bet you they can hear us talking over the fucking air. Sorry. I'm sorry, it's not you. Sorry. This is pissing me off. I don't know if you can fucking even hear the goddamn show.